Your love and affection makes my visit to this great country all the more special. From across the vast Indian Ocean, I bring with me the warm friendship and best wishes of 1.25 billion Indians. Before starting my visit, I had personally emailed to all of you, inviting your ideas and suggestions for my today's speech. On Narendra Modi app, I received thousands of innovative and useful suggestions. And these suggestions have helped me enrich my interaction with you today. Doston, we may live on distant shores, in different time zones, and on different hemispheres. Our ancestors may have been separated in history. Our nationalities may be different, and our support may be for different cricket teams. But our common cultural, religious, and spiritual heritage ensure that we remain close and connected. Both in our hearts and our minds. Friends, parson 10th July hai. Aap log jante hain kis din ka kya mahatv hai? Jante hain 10 July ka kya mahatv hai? Nahi jante na? इसी दिन 1991 10 जुलाई को साउथ अफ्रीका की क्रिकेट पर जो इंटरनेशनल सैंक्शन लगे थे वो हट गए थे. और उसके चंद महीनों के बाद ही साउथ अफ्रीका की टीम ने अपना पहला क्रिकेट मैच भारत में खेला था. और इतिहास की दूसरी पहलू देखिए, वही भारत जिसने एपार्थाइड के दौरान साउथ अफ्रीका का बहिष्कार किया था, वही भारत एपार्थाइड के बाद साउथ अफ्रीका को गले लगाने वाला सबसे पहला देश था. फ्रेंड्स, जब आप सबको देखता हूं तो मुझे आपके पुरखों, आपके एंसेस्टर्स और उनकी पीड़ा की याद आती है. साथ ही साथ उनकी बहादुरी का भी स्मरण आता है. सेंचुरीज एगो our ancestors traveled to the unknown shores of South Africa. They faced hardship and extreme poverty, yet they endured and kept going. Under decades of apartheid isolation, they not only preserved their culture, tradition, and language, they also gave them new wings to flourish. And today, the beauty of Hindi, Tamil, Gujarati, Urdu, and Telugu continues to enrich the fabric of South African society. The colors of Holi, the sparkle of Diwali, taste of Pongal, and festivities of Eid are not just the rainbow of Indian cultural and traditions. They also symbolize the vibrant diversity of South Africa. The story of your ancestors in this nation may have been of poverty and oppression, but their legacy is one of pride and sacrifice. And it is reflected in your success and prosperity. Its reality rests in your immense contribution to the economic and social well-being of this great country. In staying true to the Indian ethos of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the notion that the world is a family, we have cared for others. And in so doing, you have also accorded the South African ethos of Umuntu, Numuntu, Nagbantatu. You are what you are because of the other people. Friends, not many of you may recognize, but there is one contribution of your ancestors that you should be proud of. Your ancestors were one of the first to leave the shores of India. Their sacrifice, that determination to preserve their cultural roots and will to succeed against all odds, not only saved the generation of South African Indians, it also influenced and guided the mindset of Indian diaspora the world over. In many ways, what Indian diaspora stands for all over the world today is because of what your forefathers were able to achieve despite all adversities. Friends, this city and its people mean a lot to us. It was here that Mahatma Gandhi conceptualized his politics. This is the birthplace of Satyagraha. South Africa transformed Mohandas into a Mahatma. But Gandhi was not alone in this fight against racial oppression. The South African freedom struggle also has many heroes among you. Who can forget the sacrifice of 16-year-old Valiamma, the fearless Thambi Naidu, and the selfless Muhammad Kachalia. I had the privilege of meeting Ahmed Kathrada earlier today. He spent 26 years in prison alongside Nelson Mandela. The harshness of the Robben Island prison could not bring down Lalu Chiba, Mac Maharaj, or Billy Nair. और मेरे लिए खुशी की बात है कि आज उन सबको मुझे दर्शन करने का अवसर मिला. उन्होंने जो यातनाएं झेली थी उसके बावजूद भी उनके चेहरे की प्रसन्नता देख करके मैं एक नई प्रेरणा, नई ऊर्जा लेकर के हिंदुस्तान लौटूंगा. मैं उन सभी को जिन्होंने मूल्यों के लिए इस धरती पर इतने कष्ट झेले, कौन हिंदुस्तानी होगा जिनको ऐसे भारत मां के लाल पर नाज न हो. Alongside their African brothers and sisters, generations of Indians fought, suffered and sacrificed so that all of South Africa could breathe freely. I salute you all and the countless others dedicated to this great country. You are the proud sons and daughters of the Indian heritage. You are the proud and loyal citizens of South Africa. You are the hard-working and loyal citizens of South Africa. You are also a part of the flourishing global Indian family. You form a unique bond between our two great nations, a bond that is nurtured by our shared values and struggles, a bond on whose foundation we are building the promise of our prosperous future. Friends, South Africa is a sacred land It is the land of Madiba and the Karma Bhumi of Mahatma Gandhi. The path these two great men have shown us and the freedom that they have won for us is an inspiration for all of mankind. That tireless spirit, courage, and moral force will remain a guiding beacon for the generations to come. The Mahatma led India's march to freedom from the British, which gave birth to modern India. The forgiveness of Nelson Mandela and his long march to freedom gave a rise to our rainbow nation. Gandhi held South Africa dear to his heart. Mahatma Gandhi मानते थे कि इस भूमि पर एक प्रकार से उनका यहां एक नया जन्म हुआ था. In his farewell to South Africa in July 1914, he said, and I quote, "This subcontinent has become to me a sacred and dear land, next only to my motherland." I leave the shores of South Africa with a heavy heart, and the distance that will now separate me from South Africa, but will draw me closer to it, and its welfare will always be a matter of great concern. और आज 100 साल बाद, a century later, these very words resonate in our minds. When we think of South Africa, when we think of you, brothers and sisters, we live in a world that is interdependent and hyper-connected. Many of you are now closely engaged with developments in India. Your desire to connect with the lands of your forefathers may be an emotional urge, but you need not limit yourself to that alone. India today is also a land of opportunity for those who want to connect and collaborate, innovate and create, trade and invest, produce and engineer. India is today one of the brightest spots in the global economy. In a world marked by reducing growth rates and economic slowdown, India registered a healthy growth rate of 7.6% this year. And we are working to grow over 8% and more in the years ahead. India's dynamism is not of mere words. It is driven by concrete action. and is defined by our commitment to change the face of the Indian economy, not just through sustained rapid economic growth, but through multiple transformations. और इसीलिए तो मैं कह रहा हूं, एक बार आप लोग भी आकर के देखिए तो सही, कैसे भारत का कायाकल्प हो रहा है। ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन दैट एम टू अपलिफ्ट इंडियाज 1.25 billion people, its 500 cities and its 600,000 villages. We want enterprises to flourish, business to grow and the country to rise. For this, we are already shaping a policy framework that strengthens India's ability to build trade, manufacturing innovation, and investment partnerships with other countries in the world. Our focus on ease of doing business is aimed at ensuring that the public, private and personal businesses can grow to their full potential in India. And we want it to be driven by state of the art infrastructure that not only provides basic needs of housing, shelter, electricity, water and sanitation to the people, but also engineers a modern network of ports, airports, rail and road for them to serve as gateways of economic prosperity for our people. Our plan to build 100 smart cities is aimed at creating an urbanized society that is sustainable and easy on this environment and on our resources. Backed by the strength of the best information technology specialists in the world, we are also shaping a digital revolution. A revolution that would change the way a government engages with its citizens, a business interacts with its clients, and a society relates to its old and new structures. A revolution which rests on digital infrastructure that allows free flow of information, innovation and ideas on the information highways. Friends, India, like South Africa, is a young nation. The energy and drive of our 800 million youth fuels and mirrors the ambition and aspiration of the entire country. We want them to be the engine that pulls India's economy and society. And for this, we are working in campaign mode to skill India's youth. The plan is to generate over 500 million new jobs in India by 2022. We want them not just to fulfill India's needs, but also to meet the growing global demand of skilled manpower. It is not just the economy and society that is racing ahead. The mindsets of our people are also changing. And the change that I'm talking about is not just on paper and in our plans. It is already visible on the ground. There is a wave of new momentum in our villages. The cities are full of enterprise and energy. There is confidence in our youth, and the citizens of India are full of optimism. India's rise is a story of rare resilience, renewed resurgence, significant speed, and spectacular scale. आज भारत की कहानी केवल चार अक्षर में बयां हो सकती है. ये चार अक्षर हैं होप, HOPE. टुडे इंडिया सक्सेस स्टोरी कैन बी डिफाइंड इन जस्ट 4 letters. They are letters of HOPE, where H is for harmony, O for optimism, P for potential, and E for energy. And the credit for this does not go to Modi. It goes to 1.25 billion people of India. And to the fact that they placed their faith in my government and gave it a mandate to govern. In doing so, they opted for action over words, positivity over negative approaches, a sense of focus and purpose over a feeling of drift. Willingness to shape the international agenda rather than react to it, and transformational jump rather than incremental change. Brothers and sisters, our two countries have similar aspirations and challenges. India was one of the leaders of the international movement for freedom in this country. We led from the front in the global fight against apartheid. But, as I said earlier, as the Rainbow Nation was born, we were also the first ones to extend the warm embrace of our friendship. उसके बाद का तो इतिहास ही बिल्कुल भिन्न है. With this began a new and glorious chapter in our ties. In our economic choice, we can do many things together for our youth and for our people. both India and South Africa have huge demographic opportunities. We both have a young population. Two-thirds of our people in India are below the age of 35. Similar is the story on the African continent and in South Africa. We must share our experiences, our partnership, and our expertise to meet our development goals. As South Africa works towards economic prosperity, safety, and security for its people, it will find in India a trusted and reliable partner. India is ready to join you in this journey. Our development and business partnerships are already doing well. But we must do more to help them gallop, to run as the springbok. Together, we can create new enterprises, new skills, and new social values. India and South Africa are strategic partners. We should build a partnership that spans the entirety of the human endeavor, a partnership that scales new heights in diverse fields, from agriculture to healthcare, from culture to commerce, from tradition to trade, from industry to institution building, from investment to information technology, from mining to manufacturing, from sports to science and technology, and from defense to development. We are also active drivers of regional partnership. Together, we can create new values for our friends in Africa. Our companies are already partnering and bringing economic benefit to our people. They can also be an instrument of change on this continent. We can work together to empower youth, to fight poverty, malnutrition, disease, and hunger. Again, not just in our countries, but across Africa and in other developing regions. We live in an age of global challenges. Fight against terrorism and piracy, AIDS and Ebola are some of the key priorities of our partnership. Our partnership for economic prosperity also has to be sensitive to climate change. We agreed to a landmark deal in Paris. We now have to work together as strong partners to look at new energy pathways and technology solutions for a climate-smart world. To galvanize global action, India has started the International Solar Alliance, which has the support of over 120 countries. Solar reached South Africa is a critical partner in this program. Through IPSA, India, Brazil, and South Africa, IPSA. And BRICS, our partnership is also shaping priorities within the global agenda. Brothers and sisters, a resurgent India awaits you, and we have taken several steps towards eliminating barriers of entry. The OCI and PIO schemes have been rolled into one. In February this year, we launched e-visa for South Africa. You can now get Indian visa sitting at home in your email, and that too at no cost. Brothers and sisters, India and South Africa have much to benefit from a closer partnership. You are a window to India's heritage, to our ethos, and to our values. Your forefathers fought for South Africa's political freedom. Today, you can be a crucial contributor in South Africa's march towards economic prosperity. And you form an important lifeline of our ties with this land. In conclusion, let me share that your achievements, your contributions, and your success make us all proud. It has been a privilege for me to connect with you. It's a great opportunity. और आप हमेशा मुझसे जुड़ना चाहें तो भी जुड़ सकते हैं. मैं सोशल मीडिया में इजीली अवेलेबल रहता हूं. आप नरेंद्र मोदी ऐप डाउनलोड करके आप मुझसे लगातार संपर्क में रह सकते हैं. मैं निमंत्रण देता हूं आप लोगों को.